हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द फोर्थ टाइप ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन, दैट इज डबल डिकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शन. ओके, सो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय डबल डिकम्पोजिशन रिएक्शन? दिस इज अ टाइप ऑफ केमिकल चेंज इन विच टू कंपाउंड्स. ओके, सपोज दीज आर टू कंपाउंड्स, इन विच टू कंपाउंड्स इन अ सॉल्यूशन. ओके, दे विल बी इन द सॉल्यूशन फॉर्म. इन विच टू कंपाउंड्स इन अ सॉल्यूशन टू रिएक्ट. ओके, दे रिएक्ट विथ ईच अदर to form a new compounds. Okay, they will form two new compounds by mutual exchange of radicals. Their radicals are exchanged. You can see this D is coming here, this B is going there. Okay, so when in a chemical change in which two compounds in a solution react, okay, to form two new compounds by mutual exchange of radicals. Radicals means all of you know that in a compound one basic radical is there, one acidic radicals are there. So they are exchanging their radicals also. B is going there, D is coming here. Now see, A, D and B, C, they are forming two new compounds by mutual exchanging their radicals. Okay, so this type of reaction is called double decomposition reaction. Okay, and they are also called double displacement reaction also. Okay, these type of reactions are also called double displacement reaction also. Now these reactions are of two type. Okay, first one is precipitation reaction and second one is neutralization reaction. So first one is your precipitation reaction. A chemical reaction in which two compounds in their aqueous state react to form an insoluble salt as one of the product is known as a precipitation reaction. Okay, very good example is your silver nitrate with sodium chloride. Very good example. They both should be in aqueous form. They will be in solution form. Okay, aqueous form. When these two solutions are reacting with each other, they form a precipitate of silver chloride. Okay, precipitate means insoluble solid which cannot dissolve in that liquid. That is why it is called insoluble solid. Okay, so when these two solutions are reacting together, they form a precipitate of silver chloride and sodium nitrate will be in aqueous form. In the precipitation reaction, one product should be precipitate. Okay, so a chemical reaction in which two compounds in their aqueous state react to form an insoluble salt. Okay, that insoluble salt is called precipitate. This is the sign of precipitation. So when two compounds in their aqueous states are reacting together, they form an insoluble salt as one of the product. Okay, among these two, one should be insoluble solid. So this type of reaction is called precipitation reaction. Okay, one more example you can see, barium chloride and sodium sulfate. When these two are reacting together, we get one precipitate of barium sulfate and sodium chloride in aqueous form. Okay, thus these reactions are not balanced. I think you have to balance it. Okay, so these two are in aqueous form. When these two solutions are reacting together, they form a precipitate of barium sulfate, okay, BaSO4, okay, insoluble solid, and one sodium chloride aqueous form you will get. Okay, among these two product, one is in precipitate. So these are called precipitation reaction. Precipitation is the formation of a solute either when two solution are mixed, or the second one is when two solutions are mixed. Okay, then you will get one precipitate. And the second one is when a gas is bubbled in a solution. When a gas is bubbled in a solution. When a gas is bubbled in a solution, then you will get a precipitate. Okay, so okay, now next one is your neutralization reaction. So what do you mean by neutralization reaction? Neutralization reaction. Okay, so the reaction between an acid and a base, when one acid and one base is reacting together, okay, they form salt and water. They form salt and water as a product. So this type of reaction is called neutralization reaction. Okay, now see one example. Sodium hydroxide, it is a base, is reacting with hydrogen chloride, which is an acid. Okay, when these two basic and this acid are reacting together, they form one salt, NaCl, and water. So this type of reactions are called neutralization reaction. Okay, one more example you can see. Neutralization of a soluble base with an acid. Okay, neutralization of a soluble base. Okay, soluble base means which is dissolved in the water. Okay, so that example is potassium hydroxide. When it is reacting with HNO3, okay, this is base, this is acid. Okay, when these two are reacting together, they form a salt of potassium nitrate and water. Okay, so this is also one example of neutralization reaction. One more example, neutralization of an insoluble base with an acid. This is soluble base. Okay, now you have to see one example of insoluble base. Okay, lead oxide, PbO, it is insoluble base when it is reacting with HNO3, nitric acid, then it forms one salt and water. So these are the examples of neutralization reaction. Okay, one acid and one base is reacting together, they form salt and water. This is base, this is acid. When these two are reacting together, they form one salt and water. This is one soluble base is reacting with acid, they form salt and water. This is one insoluble base is reacting with acid, they form salt and water. Okay, now what are the uses of neutralization? Okay, when someone is stung by a bee, okay, when any person is stung by a honey bee, then formic acid enters in our body, okay, which is an acid. Okay, then formic acid enters the skin and gives us pain, which can be relieved by rubbing the spot with slaked lime or baking soda. When you rub that place with baking soda, so baking soda is a base, okay, this one is acid. So when this baking soda is rubbed on this formic acid, so they neutralize and we get relief. Okay, so this is one use of neutralization. Second one is, if our stomach gland secrete excess amount of HCl, if our stomach gland excrete excess amount of HCl, we experience pain, which is relieved by taking milk of magnesia or solution of sodium hydrogen carbonate. Okay, if we mix sodium hydrogen carbonate, NaHCO3, so this one is acid, this one is base. So when these two are mixed together, they neutralize and we get relief. Okay, now third use of neutralization, acid that is accidentally spilled onto our clothes or body can be neutralized with ammonia solution. Okay, suppose in our body or in our clothes we got an acid, so immediately if we pour some ammonia solution, it will be neutralized. Now the last one, if the soil is somewhat acidic, okay, for the growth of the crops, if the soil is acidic, then slaked lime is added to neutralize it. Okay, then slaked lime is added to neutralize this excess amount of acid. So these were the uses of neutralization. Okay, now I'm going to give you the exercise of 2B. Okay, I'm going to give you the exercise of 2B. First one is complete. complete the following sentences. First one, A. Your answer is displacement. Second one, in the type of reaction called two compounds exchange their positive and negative radicals. Just now I explained double decomposition. Third one, a catalyst either accelerate or decelerate. Accelerate or decelerate. Fourth one, only one single C will be the D-E-C-E, okay, accelerate or decelerate. In the fourth one, on heating hydrated copper sulfate changes its color from blue to white. Blue to white. Now question number two, when hydrogen burns in oxygen, water is formed. It is not balanced, okay. Water is formed. So when electricity is passed through water, then hydrogen and oxygen are given out. So name the type of chemical changes involved in the two cases. This one is first case, this one is second case. So first case, which type of reaction it is? First one is direct combination. Okay, because one product is there, so that is why it is direct combination. And in the second one, you can see one compound is breaking into two elements. So this one is decomposition reaction. Okay, now third one, explain giving one example for each. Okay, first one, double decomposition reaction. One example you will get in page number 28. Thermal dissociation, you will get this example in page number 27. Reversible reaction also you will get in page number 27. Displacement reaction, you will get example in page number 27. Okay, now fourth question, what is synthesis? You will get in page number 24. Synthesis is also called direct combination reaction or combination reaction. Okay, now part B. What kind of chemical reaction is synthesis? So it is direct combination reaction. And one example for this you will get in page number 24. One example you will get. So many examples are there. Fifth one, decomposition brought up about heat is known as thermal decomposition. What is the difference between thermal dissociation and thermal decomposition? So this both definition you will get in page number 25 and 27. In 25 you will get the definition of thermal decomposition, and in page number 27 you will get the definition of thermal dissociation. So you have to write the difference between these two. Okay, definition you write. Okay, so this will be the difference between these two. Now question number 6, define neutralization reaction with one example in page number 28 you will get. Give a balanced equation for this reaction in page number 28, right side you will get. So many examples are given. Okay, B. Now C1, give three applications of neutralization reaction in page number 28, right side. So many uses are there. Okay, bee sting and hydrogen chloride and soil is acidic. Okay, just now I explained you. So among this four application you can write any three applications, any three uses. Now question number 7, what do you understand by precipitation reaction? Explain with one example in page number 28, left side you will get. Just now I explained also. Okay, first you have to write the definition of the precipitation reaction with one example. Question number 8, what are double displacement reaction you will get in page number 28. Okay, just now I explained. Give an example of double displacement reaction where a gas is evolved. Okay, I am giving you this example where a gas is evolved. Zinc sulfide is reacting with hydrogen chloride. This will be in the solid form, this will be in the aqueous form. You will get zinc chloride in aqueous form and hydrogen gas. Okay, so this is the answer of question number 8, part B. Now question number 9. What is a decomposition reaction? Question number 9. Your question number 9 is, what is a decomposition reaction? You will get in page number 25. Okay, now part B. This is part A. Give an example. Decomposition reaction can occur by heat, electricity and sunlight. For heat also you have to give 2 examples. For electricity also you have to give 2 examples, and for light also you have to give 2 examples. Okay, so for heating I am giving you 1 example or 2 example. It is given also in your book. This will be in the liquid form. Second one, calcium carbonate, when you heat it, heat symbol you write, you will get calcium oxide in solid form plus carbon dioxide gas. For electricity, one very good example of water, if you pass electricity in this, you will get hydrogen and oxygen. One more example, second example, potassium chlorate. See, the reactions are balanced or not. If it is not balanced, you have to balance it. Okay, for heat also I have given 2, for electricity 2, for light 1. Silver bromide in solid form in the presence of sunlight. Second example, hydrogen peroxide in liquid form in the presence of light. It decomposes into water and oxygen gas. It is in liquid form. Okay, so this is your question number 9. Now question number 10. In this, state the type of reactions each of the following represent and balance. First you have to balance all the reactions. Then you have to write that which type of reaction it is. So first one is your displacement reaction. Second one is your neutralization reaction. I am writing in short. Third one is your decomposition reaction. I am writing in short. Fourth one is displacement reaction. Fifth one, synthesis or combination reactions you can write. Next one, decomposition. Next one, again decomposition. Next one, double decomposition. Next one, displacement. Next one, decomposition. In short, I am writing. Next one is again decomposition. L, neutralization. And last one is your double decomposition reaction. Okay, now question number 11. Match the following. क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 इज मैच द फॉलोइंग. फर्स्ट वन यू हैव टू मैच विद थर्ड वन. सेकेंड वन यू हैव टू मैच विद फर्स्ट वन. थर्ड वन यू हैव टू मैच विद फोर्थ वन. एंड लास्ट वन यू हैव टू मैच विद सेकेंड वन. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 12 मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट वन सेकेंड आंसर इज करेक्ट. सेकेंड वन थर्ड आंसर इज करेक्ट. थर्ड वन फोर्थ आंसर इज करेक्ट. एंड लास्ट वन फर्स्ट आंसर इज करेक्ट. ओके सो फॉर टुडे दिस मच. इन माय नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई विल एक्सप्लेन द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर. थैंक यू सो मच.